So now we'll study about the losses on a transformer. We can talk about the power losses on a transformer as there are two major power losses in a transformer. These are, the first one is copper losses in transformer, and the second one is iron losses in transformer. Let's discuss both of these one by one in detail. If we talk about the copper losses, about copper losses, we can write that these are dissipation losses due to winding resistance of transformer coils. The wires of which the transformer primary and secondary coils are made up of, these always have some Joule heating effects because of their resistances, so some heat is dissipated in the coils. Here we can write, if coil resistances of a transformer are Rp and Rs, here Rp is the resistance of the primary coil and Rs is the resistance of the secondary coil, then we can write total copper loss in a transformer circuit due to coil resistance is, this is termed as PLC, power loss due to resistances of primary and secondary coil, which is termed as copper loss. This is written as IP square RP plus IS square RS, where IP is the current in the primary circuit or the primary coil of the transformer, RP is the resistance of the primary coil, IS is the current in the secondary coil of transformer, and RS is the resistance in secondary coil. So this is the total copper loss in transformer due to the winding resistances, and it is termed as the copper loss in a transformer. Let's continue on the next sheet. We'll study in detail about iron losses in a transformer. In continuation, let's study about iron losses in a transformer. About iron losses, we can write that these are dissipation losses in the core of a transformer due to eddy currents, because of time varying magnetic flux in the core. Here we can understand it better with the help of a realistic situation. Here you can see, this is a transformer in which when a time varying current flows in the primary coil, a time varying magnetic flux is produced, which induces an EMF in the secondary coil, and which in result produces a current in secondary coil. Now here, if we just have a look on the magnetic flux in the core, it also varies with time. And if we just have a look into the cross section of this core, if the core is made up of a solid metal, you can see eddy currents are produced in the core of this transformer. And at every local point, due to eddy currents, thermal energy is dissipated. And this energy dissipation comes from actually the power which is being transferred from primary coil to secondary coil through the core. So this dissipation loss, so we call the iron loss in the transformer core, which are mainly because of the eddy currents in the transformer. There is no direct way by which we can measure the iron losses in a transformer like copper losses, which can be directly calculated by Joule heating. Here, iron losses in a transformer can be measured simply as total loss minus the copper loss in the transformer. Copper loss can be mathematically calculated, and total loss we can measure by the power which is supplied by the primary coil or consumed by the primary coil as EPIP, and we subtract the power which is extracted out from the secondary coil, which is ESIS. This is the total power loss in the transformer, and from the total loss, if we subtract the copper loss, we can get the total iron losses. This is the total iron losses in the transformer. This is the only way by which we can calculate the iron losses. There is no direct method by which mathematically iron loss in the transformer can be measured. However, there are some ways out by which we can reduce the iron losses. The best way out to reduce the iron losses is to make the core, which is to make the core by laminated sheets rather than using a solid core. Here you can just have a look in the situation where you can see this is a thin laminated metal sheet. If several such sheets are placed one after another, the core is made, and on winding primary and secondary coil on this laminated stripped core, you can see when a current flows through the primary coil, magnetic flux is produced, but the cross section is insulated in form of strips from one part to another. So you can see eddy currents are produced, but with very small end path, and the majority of eddy currents are cut because of the insulating lamination layer between the strips, because of which the eddy current path is reduced and effective dissipation loss due to eddy current is also decreased. This is a way by which iron losses are reduced. If you have seen transformers practically in labs, so you might have seen that the core is not made up of a solid ferromagnetic material. It is made up of laminated strips. This is because to reduce the iron losses in the transformer core only.